Tip. Happy birthday. Where's your toy? Whoa! He's up on top of me. He jumped right up onto me. Tippo, you're back. I love you.
Memorial to a dog. She came all the way from Illinois by train in a big wooden crate many years ago. A frightened black poodle, not yet a year old. She felt terrible in body and worse in mind. These contraptions that men put on wheels, in contravention of that law of nature which holds that the feet must come in contact with the ground in traveling, dismayed her. She was never able to ride 1,000 yards in an automobile without getting sick at her stomach. But she was always apologetic about this frailty. Never, as she might well have been, reproachful. She tried patiently at all times to understand man's way of life. The rolling of his wheels, the raising of his voice, the ringing of his bells, his way of searching out with lights the dark protecting corners of the night, his habit of building his beds inside walls high above the nurturing earth. She refused, with all courtesy, to accept his silly notion that it is better to bear puppies in a place made of machine wood and clean blue cloth than in the dark and warm dirt beneath the oak flooring of the barn. The poodle was hand in glove with natural phenomena. She raised 2 litters of puppies, taking them in her stride, the way she took the lightning and the snow. One of these litters, which arrived ahead of schedule, was discovered under the barn floor by a little girl of 2. The child gaily displayed on her right forearm the almost invisible and entirely painless marks of teeth, which had gently induced her to put down the live black toys she had found and wanted to play with. The poodle had no vices that I can think of, unless you could count her incurable appetite for the tender tips of the young asparagus in the garden and for the black raspberries when they ripened on the bushes in the orchard. Sometimes, as punishment for her depredations, she walked into bees' nests or got her long, shaggy ears tangled in fence wire. She never snarled about the penalties of existence or whimpered about the trials and grotesqueries of life with man. She accepted gracefully the indignities of the clipping machine, which, in her maiden days, periodically made a clown out of her for the dog shows, in accordance with the stupid and unimaginative notion that this most sensitive and dignified of animals is at heart a buffoon. The poodle, which can look as husky as a Briard when left shaggy, is an outdoor dog and can hold its own in the field with the best of the retrievers, including the Labrador. The poodle won a great many ribbons in her bench days, but she would have traded all her medals for a dish of asparagus. She knew it was showtime when the red rubber bib was tied around her neck. That meant her riding a car to bedlam. Like the great Gemmire of Tarkington's Gentle Julia, the poodle I knew seemed sometimes about to bridge the mysterious and conceivably narrow gap that separates instinct from reason. She could take part in your gaiety and your sorrow. She trembled to your uncertainties and lifted her head at your assurances. There were times when she seemed to come close to a pitying comprehension of the whole troubled scene and what lies behind it. If poodles, who walk so easily upon their hind legs, ever do learn the little tricks of speech and reason, I should not be surprised if they made a better job of it than man, who would seem to be surely, but not slowly, slipping back to all fours. The poodle kept her sight, her hearing, and her figure up to her quiet and dignified end.
How are your fish?
She knew that the hand was upon her, and she accepted it with grave and unapprehensive resignation.
Your fish swimming with you, Tip?
This, her dark, intelligent eyes seemed to be trying to tell me.
Did you lose your football in there?
Is simply the closing of full circle. This is the flower that rose out of beginning.
You lost your football in the pond.
Not to make it too hard for your friend.
Uh-oh.
Is as natural as eating the raspberries and raising the puppies. and riding into the rain.
Now I'm not going in there and getting that football, so you guys better find it. That's the last football we have. You don't seem to like this new toy we bought you, so you're just crap out of luck if you don't find that football. Be careful of the fins, please, boys. Got it, Smut Tip? Can feel it. Yeah, it's got big holes in it because you've been chewing it. Uh-oh, that's the end of it. No more football. It's a sad day at 15 Mark Street.